will attempt to do something that has never been done on the stage before.
Ooh.
We will require the assistance of two judges.
So may I please ask Bruno?
Oh God, not me.
And Amanda.
Again,
join
Amanda.
Us on the stage. Oh, and take a seat.
Have you fixed this, my son? To torture me.
Hey, do you want me here? Yes,
please. Be kind.
Amanda, may I please ask you to pick a number between 1 and 5?
I want it to be number 1.
Oh, excellent choice right there. Because all the other cards are blank. Please remember that word, though.
Horny.
We will need it. So, judges, what was the word that was written on the card, please?
Pony.
Pony.
Circus of men.
Oh!
Yeah. That was genius. You've made Bruno's dream come true.
You made my life and you made everybody's life, don't you think? Let me hear it.
You still got somebody's belt around your neck.
Yeah. That was so surprising.
Okay, I think I know where this is going. Bruno, yes or no?
Oh, what do you think? Yes!
Yes!
Alicia.
I'm gonna say yes.
It's gonna be alright. Amanda.
Yes, yes, yes!
And that means you are through to the next round.
Hello.
Hello.
Right, what's your name?
It's Peter Raj.
I hope Amanda is ready. For Peter Graj.
2 years ago, I decided I want to come on the programme to meet Amanda.
Oh!
Do you have a crush on Amanda?
Well, I guess you could call it that if you want to. I wouldn't be afraid for someone to say that, but I like Amanda.
You like older women?
Right, jokes aside, what are you going to do today?
I sort of wrote a song and...
For Amanda?
Yes.
Peter!
This is so romantic.
I think you should sit on the stage and Peter sing it to you.
Oh,
we'll get a chair.
What's a gentleman?
Oh, thanks, David. Excellent. We want to make this moment as special as we can for you, Peter.
Peter. I'll tell you what, Peter's come to life now.
I need some water now.
Oh, you want water?
We've got some water for Peter.
Here we go, Peter, Peter, here we go. Don't walk out, it's my glass.
Do it for me, Peter.
Okay.
Come on.
Had to overcome fear just to get this near. Amanda, one so dear.
Oh.
crisscross I appear, like shooting star, one moment heart to heart. Amanda, remember me, Amanda.
Amanda, she'll remember you, Peter.
Remember me, Amanda.
And
remember
our security.
Time we came together. Time we spent
I
together.
Not work.
Can't be everywhere. Friend in a stranger. Stranger still injustice.
Go. Oh, look, he's got his handy on our Mandy.
Look, Peter, I don't know where this is going to lead to, but it was sweet. But the song was terrible, if I'm being honest with you, Peter.
It wasn't good.
The good news is that I'm paying for dinner tonight.
Serious about that?
With a meal, just get your strength up. It's going to be a long night. Yeah. I mean, eat, you know what I mean? Eat everything you can.
It's a no today from me.
Oh, Peter, I'm saying yes.
Simon?
I'm going to say no.
I'm going to say no, I'm sorry.
Oh. Thank you for coming, Peter.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Christian Lee.
Where are you from, Christian?
I am from London.
Do you have a day job?
I do have a day job. It's a magician.
Christian, are you married?
I am engaged.
To who?
To someone who's going to be my wife.
Do you have kids together?
Yeah, they're in the car outside, so...
OK, when you're ready, off you go.
OK, I'm going to need an assistant. One of you judges will be that. And it's going to be you, Amanda.
Helps up the stairs these days.
Kindly hold the cards. That's all we have to do. Even better. Last night I had a dream. A dream that you and I would be standing together here on stage. We were holding hands. That's right, willingly. And swaying to the music. It was a kind of out of time sway, but eventually we found our rhythm. You wanted to go all the way and name a card into the microphone. A card. Just name a card. But before you got there, there was a loud voice. It was my voice, and the dream was over. I did remember, though, the card that you nearly said. In fact, I'm going to use my mind powers. Could I have my mind-enhancing device, please?
Yes. Here you go. There you go, sir.
Pop this on like this. Here we go. Time to put the card into your mind.
Okay.
Amanda, name the card that is now in your mind.
The Six of Hearts.
Six of Hearts, you say? If you could just take the one card that is the only card facing the other way around, take it out, slide it out, and show them, and live the dream.
It is the Six of Hearts.
How I did it is not so important. It's how I'm going to get this balloon off. If you could just come round here and just grab me round the waist. Come on, come on!
Yeah, I like that. That was very good.
What did you think?
What I love about this show is it gives someone like you a chance for a much bigger audience, and you absolutely deserve it. You're brilliant.
I mean, you entertained us so brilliantly well. Thank you, Greg.
I think you're funny, but I didn't think the trick was great or the magic was great. Are you really good, or should you be doing children's parties? And I can't quite make my mind up.
Children's parties?
I completely agree with David. You know, you're very, very funny, which is what makes it so entertaining.
Let's vote.
It's a really easy yes. Well done.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
OK, I'm going to say yes.
Good!
David.
You just got four yeses!
Well done! Very funny stuff.
That was amazing.
Thank you so much.
Amazing.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
What's your name, sir?
My name is Maddox.
Why are you on Britain's Got Talent?
I am desperate to perform magic to an audience just like this. And magic has always been a dream of mine, and last year I decided to take the plunge and to do it full time.
Best of luck.
Thank you very much. Now, if I was to show you all something up here on stage with this Rubik's Cube, I'd be worried that because our judges are a little far away, they might actually miss the moment. The cube solves itself. So if it's okay with you, please might I come down and show you this close up?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Now, a Rubik's Cube, turn them and mix them up, they get jumbled up real fast. And then the only way to get it back to the beginning is to get all the colors to come back together. I want you to look just here for me and watch one by one. You can actually see those colors start to reassemble themselves.
How does he do that?
I have no idea.
Alicia, would you be so kind to give this a really good mix-up for me? Keep turning and mixing it. And whilst you're doing that,
Alicia, come on.
Simon, I'd love for you to help me also. I've got another cube here. It's not mixed up. I don't want you to mix it up. I just want you to choose a color, and whatever color you choose, put it on the top to say you chose yellow, put it on top and cover it up so no one can see it. Is that okay?
Yeah.
How are we getting on, Alicia?
Yeah, all good.
Lovely. Let's check this out. Okay. Now, if you were to look at this cube, you can see all the colors mixed up all over. Now, Simon, can you see the color you've chosen on
yeah.
the cube?
Yeah.
Alicia, would you mind putting your hand flat like a table for me, just like this? We'll put it just up here. And I want you to stay perfectly still for me, just like that. Now, Simon, we're just going to reveal the color that you chose, if that's okay. The color white, is that correct?
Yeah.
Now, Alicia, all I want you to do is look right here, and I want you to think of the color white. Watch. One, two, three. White just vanished from every single side of this cube.
What?
Every side. But the side. Now, before I finish, Amanda, I would love to try one last thing with you on stage. Would you mind coming up for me for a moment? Thank you. Thank you, Amanda.
You're welcome.
Now, if you look at the cube, when people are trying to solve it, they basically pay attention to where every single piece is before they find the solution. But we're not going to have you do that. We're going to have you solve this Rubik's Cube without even thinking about it. So, okay. Put both your hands behind your back like this. Now, I want you to turn the cube behind your back just like this. But that's all I want you to do, okay?
Fine.
Now, I'm going to give you one last look. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let me know when you feel it in your hands. That's great. And just start to turn it, just as I showed you. That's great. Perfect. So I want you to believe, Amanda, that you can solve that
Rubik's
Cube.
I can do this. I can do it.
You can do it, Amanda!
Thank you, Dad.
She's got this. Now, I want you to stop turning the cube. Now, close your eyes for me. audience, there's 43 quintillion different ways to mix up a Rubik's Cube. And wouldn't it be amazing if, Amanda, you could do the impossible thing tonight? Not me, but you.
It'd be a bloody miracle.
3, 2, 1. Put it in front. Open your eyes.
See that?
It looks weird, isn't it? Welcome. What's your name, please?
It's Elisabeth.
Elisabeth?
Just Elisabeth.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
Because I want to show you something special and try and make the impossible possible.
Well, the stage is yours, Elisabeth.
Theatres of London's West End, it's said to be haunted by many ghosts. In 1919, the great Harry Houdini appeared on stage and offered a large cash sum for anyone who could prove the existence of them. Amanda, I'd like you to take this journal in your left hand, and I'd like you to come with me.
I'm scared.
Legends have said that spirits departed walk the halls and stores of the theatres of London. It is said to be good luck to see ghosts for a performer. For others, not so much.
You look scared.
Oh my God. Where are we going?
That's under the stage.
Amanda, please take a seat. These photographs are of people who have lived and died over 100 years ago.
I'm kind of creeped out.
Can you hold out your left hand like this? Now, in a moment, I want you to count these photographs face down onto the table, one at a time. When you place them down, you're going to feel a connection to one. When you feel that connection, I want you to stop and to place that photograph face down into this cigar box. Look at the photographs. Each and every one is different, but you were drawn to one and you don't know why.
No.
Open the cigar box and take out the photograph that you chose. Turn it over and read out what it says.
Agatha Turner, 1860.
Before this all began, I gave you a journal that's over 100 years old. Open the page I've bookmarked and read out the paragraph that I've circled in red.
Miss Turner was born in the 1800s. She loved visiting the West End to be entertained. She tragically died in 1860, and her ghost is said to haunt the theatres that she once loved.
Amanda, this moment was always meant to be. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh, my God!
A judge to come in, join me in the show. Amanda, are you available now?
Amanda,
are you available?
Am I available? Yes. Let me just check my diary.
Thank you. Take your seat. This experience is about time travel. In the glass, we have a brand new deck of cards. It's still sealed. It's brand new. Please touch it. Check it out. It's still sealed.
It feels new.
Yeah, it's new deck. No, new deck of cards. You can see all the cards in new deck order, right? Can you see it?
Yeah.
Now, would you please shuffle the deck for me? It's a new deck of cards, right?
New deck.
It's
very
brand new.
New.
Yes.
It's new.
You're sure, right?
I'm so sure it's new, yes.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Amanda. Now, I will, doing like this, show you all the cards are different, and you can tell me anywhere stop you want, just anywhere you want.
Stop there.
Really?
Yeah.
You sure? Okay. So, I'll show you the card.
Okay.
Seven of diamonds, right? Would you please sign them for me? Make a big, special signature on the face of the card, the seven of diamonds, yes. Perfect. Perfect. Now this card is a magic. This card has a very special abilities. This card can travel through the space. You can see the face of the card, right? You can see the back of the card. The seven of diamonds. Watch! The seven of diamonds jump from one side to another. You traveled. Oh, thank you. This car not only travels through the space, you can see, now the two joker is gone. Wait a moment. And this car can travel through the time. Now everything go back to the very beginning. The story begins with a brand new deck of cards. So in the glass, we have a brand new deck of cards. Please check it out.
Take yes,
it
they're
out.
New. They are.
Yeah, check it out.
They're new. There's a seal and they're very new. They are.
It's very new.
They're very new, Bill.
Perfect. I hope so. A new deck of cards normally begin with...
Two jokers.
Two jokers.
Yes.
Let me see. And falling with... Ace of Kings, right? I can see two jokers. Falling with Ace to Kings. Ace to Kings, you stop anywhere. There's only one card in between the Six of Diamonds and the Eight of Diamonds. There's only one card face down. Do you still remember? You put a signature on it, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is the only one card with your signatures. Please check it out. Is it your signature?
That's my signature.
Yes. Thank you very much.
That's my card.
Wait a moment. You can see all the cards back in new deck order, the red deck of cards, right, in new deck order from Ace to Kings. But before you shuffle the deck, before we open the deck, even before it printed, it's only some piece of blank papers on both sides. You can see on both sides some blank pieces. Papers. I still remember you signed the one card.
I did sign it.
The Seven of Diamonds. But before you signed it, before you tell me stop, even before I opened the deck, before the deck printed, it is only a piece of blanco papers.
What? What?
Check it out. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy my illusion. Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Why are you not doing?
Good evening.
Only you.
Is it you not doing it?
I did it.
She did it.
Huh? I said it.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I need a volunteer. You. Come up on stage. What's your name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yes.
Tell the truth. Is that you?
Yes.
Here I have two boxes. I want you to choose one of the boxes. Now, turn around back to back. I want you to open the box. Inside, you will find plastic bags with different colors. Mm-hmm. I want you to think at one of the colors and take it out. Now, put the box on the floor. Open the plastic bag with two ends and think on the color. Now, I want you to count to 10 slowly, and both of us will turn to the audience at the same time. Mm-hmm. Start counting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Well, wait, start from the beginning.
1, 2, 3.
Slowly.
1, 2.
Yeah, now it's good.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Thank you. It's souvenir.
Thank you.
But wait.
Oh.
No, I took something from you. You didn't even notice. Chegwood, what did I take from you?
Much.
I took something from you. You're missing something. Here is your watch.
Thank you. Oh, it's good.
And you? I took something from you too. Good, what did I take from you? Here is your watch! And you? No, your wallet! What's inside? Your watch! Thank you! Thank you!
Oh, he's got it!
I'm Freddy, I'm 35 years old and I'm from Sweden.
Lovely! Why Britain's Got Talent?
This stage, it needs a proper science show.
Oh.
So you're going to make science interesting?
I hope so. I hope so.
Do you think you can win the show, Freddie?
I would say that the British people want more science show, and I'm here to bring them.
Do we want more science shows?
Not really.
Go for it, Freddie.
So, Amanda Holden, you have to be my science lab assistant. Welcome up. So, we first need to get you properly dressed.
You can never be too careful.
That's perfect.
It's inside out.
No, it's cheap.
This will look good on you.
None of these guys are wearing them, though.
No, they're dispensable.
Anything happens to you guys, doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So, are you ready for some science?
Yes.
So, we will first start over here. Do you know how clouds are formed?
Well, it's to do with evaporation. Oh, Simon, it's true!
Okay, so we will make a cloud here at Palladium. So you will take this bucket, like this.
Yes.
And we're going to put it in the liquid nitrogen. 1, 2, 3, go!
Oh,
my legs up.
And now we're going to do something called elephant's toothpaste.
Yeah, we all know elephant's toothpaste, don't we?
Yeah.
This is hydrogen peroxide, oxygen molecule. And here we have potassium iodide. Put it in, all in one. Liquid nitrogen expands 700 times when it goes from liquid to gas again. We're going in. So 2,000 ping pong balls. And we're waiting. And we're waiting.
Oh, what's it going on? That's a shame for him. The final one hasn't worked. It did work, guys! It won't put the rug on!
Thank you!
Freddy, 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 Freddy. Oh, I love your confidence. I'm saying yay!
I love the madness of it all. It's a very good idea, or it's a yes.
I think this has got potential to be very entertaining.
I'm saying yes. Simon, what did you think?
I think we can make you interesting, Freddy. In my head, I can imagine dancing scientists. So I'm going to say yes.
Yes!
Now, guys, what you're about to see has never been done on British television before. And the deck. Bring it on. Now, what I'm about to do is a trick that I actually invented myself. I never really had the budget to do an amazing illusion, so I decided to make one myself. Manda, please could you join me on stage?
That is a cardboard box.
Are you okay with that?
Oh my goodness.
Nice to meet you, Manda.
Thank you.
Okay, now what you're about to see is gonna blow your mind, okay? And this is a box that I've made myself. I'm gonna open it.
I can
it
tell. Oh, Amanda, don't do it.
Take a seat for me.
That's quite narrow, you know.
It'll be fine, you'll get in. Lean back for me. Lean back a bit more. Lean back. You can do it, Amanda. Okay. You're in completely safe hands. And I've also just made something just for you, Amanda, an arm bit. And you can actually move your arm out, put your arm out. We can confirm that's you. Perfect. Okay. Now, before we continue, I do need my very special magic wand.
Uh-oh.
And I'm going to show you exactly what that is.
Oh,
this is my magic wand. Amanda, are you ready?
Yep.
More importantly, guys, are you ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, let's do this. And if this has worked correctly, your judge, Amanda, should now be completely...
Cos we're gonna be on the
floor!
Will she be able to move them legs?
And could you give your legs a wiggle for me, Amanda? These are your legs.
Oh, my God.
And now, before I put you back together, Amanda, I've got a question for you. Is it a yes or is it a no? What, now, depending on what your answer is, I might not put you back together. So what is it? Is it a yes?
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes, thank you. I thought I was a bit young for you, but thank you so much. I'm going to open this up. Come up for me. Right up, all the way. Your joke.
Thank you.
Thank you. Return back to your seat. Big round of applause. I'm Daniel Rhodes. Thank you. Good night.
On this table over here, I've written over 100 words that describe emotions that people can feel when they watch magic. Amanda, can you please join me up on stage? On your way up, can you please pick up a piece of paper and look at it? Don't let anyone else see and don't tell me.
Okay.
Can you please sit here? Start to mix this, we'll explain what's about to happen. With the help of my friends from the Magic Circle Young Magicians Club.
The Young Magicians Club.
We're going to do some magic that should hopefully blow your mind. Behind us is a framework containing 16 holes that fit a Rubik's Cube exactly. Each of my friends is holding a Rubik's Cube. Just like you, they're randomly mixing. At any point, Amanda, I'd like you to stop it from your Rubik's Cube. When you do, in a loud voice, please say stop and hold your cube high in the air.
Stop.
Now, Amanda, there are 200 quintillion ways that a Rubik's Cube can be mixed. All the cubes are mixed in a different way that nobody could possibly know. Everyone in the audience, if you've got a phone, can you please switch the torch on and hold it high in the air?
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.
Remaining. Do you want to mix your cubes some more or leave it as it is?
I'm going
to
leave it as it is.
Now, before this all began, when you had first sat down with me, I asked you to pick a word. What was that word?
It was love.
I'll just start then.
Just start.
Do you think it would be any good?
No.
Hello! My name's Graham, and it's now time for some magic. And for my magic tonight, I'm going to need a glamorous assistant. Amanda, could you join me on the stage? Let's have a big cheer for Amanda, everybody.
Woo! That big enough for you?
Now, what we're going to do tonight is me and Amanda are going to do some magic. First of all, I'm going to start with a simple magic trick. So I've got some cards here tonight. I've got a birthday card. I've got a wedding card. I've got a get well soon card. I've got welcome to your new home and happy birthday, generic pink. So I'm going to place the cards face down because that's what all the magicians do. What one do you want to go for, Amanda?
This one.
That one. Have a look, Amanda. Lovely. And I will now predict what card Amanda has picked.
Amanda.
Yeah?
I've forgotten what one it was. Now... Now, Amanda, I've written a word on the piece of paper just here. Do you know what the word says?
No.
No, that's correct. No. And now I have two cups at the bottom of the water. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. There's water going in that one. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. A little bit more in that one, a little bit more in that one. And now, before your very eyes, me and Magic Amanda will make the water disappear. Amanda, if you put the cup on your head like that, Amanda, could you hold that with one hand for me? Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. So we're going to do the magic water dance. And ladies and gentlemen, the magic water dance will make the water disappear. Let's do this, yeah. Right. Okay, I'll do the dance first. You go right foot, left foot, you turn around, you face the back, you bend your knees three times, and then you wiggle your bottom three times. Yeah, now make the water disappear. Your turn, off you go. Right foot, left foot, turn around, face the back, three knee bends, three bottom wiggles. Give her a big cheer, everybody. The water dance has made the water disappear. Do you cut feel lighter, Amanda?
No.
That's a problem. I'll go first. Here we go. Three, two, one. Yeah! Amanda, trust the magic. I promise you, if you trust the magic and believe in the magic, you will not get wet. Slowly turn it over. Do you want me to sip it over for you? Go, Amanda. Trust the magic, Amanda. Three, two, one. That is magic. Ladies and gentlemen, big cheer for Amanda.
Wow. Wow, it's gone cold all of a sudden.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Oh. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose. Like the child that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it. To teach a lesson in loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theater's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. You are holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet, Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Joy.
Amanda, I want you to take a deep breath and tell everyone what Alicia is holding in her right hand.
A dummy. No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
Nothing is as it seems. God in the in-between.
I don't know what to say. I mean, what do I do now? I mean, there's no one here. I don't know what just happened. What do you want to say to the ghost?
I loved it, and I'm confused, and I feel weird.
And me.
It's one of the most extraordinary things we've ever seen in this show. I love it. So, look, let me kick this off with a yes.
Yes from me.
Well, I'm gonna say yes, of course. He's got me. I mean, I feel like he wants me to say yes.
I don't know where you are, by the way. You could be anywhere. Assuming you're up there, in which case, you have four yeses. Congratulations.
Just guess that I had a dummy.
It was the weirdest thing. It was the first thing that came into my head.
Spooky. It's spooky. It's fantastic. I love that kind of stuff.